reviewable because the whistle blew that play dead. And McNair steps up, fumble, and recovered. Robert Mathis knocked it loose. And Monte Rager recovers it.
Look at that. That ball comes out and there's no question. This is a fumble and a recovery for the Indianapolis Colts. Look at 98 using the right hand. Mathis comes in, knocks the ball out.
Eddie Berlin inside the five for Tennessee. And they stop him shy of the 20-yard line.
The ball
and
came out
fumble.
Again.
And they got it. The Colts.
He makes a break to the left, and clearly the ball is out. Mathis pops it loose.
For the Falcons on second and 15. Vic looked to throw again. Down he goes. He lost the football. And it's scooped up by Freeney.
It's the rookie Robert Mathis that comes around the outside. See, that's what happens when you're a quarterback that likes to get out of the pocket. I mean, Todd Weiner thought that he was in good shape on Robert Mathis, and he wasn't. Because Vic started to move and drift in the pocket.
The quarterback has to make a play on third down and five. Ball on the field. It is picked up by a lineman.
Byron Leftwich has been criticized. He holds his ball down his waist. You see how he holds it. He's got it in his chest right there. But watch when the ball is slapped, it's way down low.
We'll outscore them, and that's what they do, and they seem happy with it.
Collins looking for a third option. He's hit from behind and fumbles. Falls right on it.
Robert Mathis from the outside. To say he's a fast defensive end is an understatement. Maybe the fastest in the NFL.
Johnson, Bradford, and Gaffney. Blocked by Juan. Ball is knocked free. It is a fumble retrieved by Spears.
Specifically, Mathis and Freeney are just blazing on this team. That's Mathis getting that late hit.
The Colts 45-yard line from the gun car. Here they come again. Mathis has him. Another fumble.
Coming from his left defensive end position, just blows right by Marcus Spears. I mean, a severe speed mismatch.
Right before our eyes.
He is the pro in this league right now.
Third and six for Carr, hit by Mathis. Fumble on the play, it's loose. And scooped up by Bob Sanders. Here comes the rookie. It's another Colt touchdown. Made his first NFL start last week on Monday night against the Vikings.
Down at 12 at the 35. Renzel in trouble as it's backed away.
Because Robert Mathis is amazing, and we talk to him. Every time he gets to a quarterback, it seems like he's stripping the ball. I had three last week.
96 catches tonight. 8 grabs, 99 yards. Right, look out from behind. A fumble, loose ball picked up by Raheem Brock.
Did you see old Raheem throw the stiff arm? Here he comes. Here comes Mathis around us. And look at that. He just ducked underneath.
Trailing by seven. Leftwich laying with the tender knee. Has it stripped out of his hands.
Smith fumbles. Recovered by Larry Triplett of the Colts.
And Robert Mathis, that lightning quick defensive end. You saw him reach in and stab at it, knock it free. And Triplett recovered.
Third and 14. Four-man rush. They get to Martin. The arm is coming forward. There's no flag. And Robert Mathis comes in there to create that back at the two-yard line.
Watch, here's Freeney there. You see, he just spins and boom, right there. But as you said, Mathis beat him to it. Mathis is speeding from the other side. Freeney from one side.
Didn't even see the rush coming. Look at this. A moment for Monte Rager. Play is live. No penalty markers down.
Yeah, there. I mean, this game's over. Put it to bed.
Yeah, well, it should be barring a defensive foul here. But Indianapolis forces the turnover as Robert Mathis gets there.
Probably the classiest in the NFL. Morency from the 10. Fumbles the ball. And the Texans have it.
First and goal at the 7. And he keeps it here. And fumbles the ball.
But again, another Indianapolis Colt comes in and puts his helmet right on the football. That time, Robert Mathis.
Carr hit again, fumble on the play. Recovered.
Kevin, crowd noise is such an issue, and these tackles are late getting out of their stance. And you watch Mathis, he just beats Leiter at the field. He's got no chance. David Carr cannot feel that pressure, and Mathis gets his hands on the ball.
Straight drop, hit from behind, lost the football. It is free, and the Colts cover it at the 26-yard line.
Take a look at the left side of your screen. That's DeBrickashaw Ferguson working against Robert Mathis. Mathis and Freeney will change up positions, and Robert Mathis with a speed rush collapses the corner and tomahawks the right arm of Chad Pennington.
Is that necktie?
Absolutely. And under the sweatshirt. From the 20, Garcia gets hit as he throws, and it's a loose ball, and it's picked up by Kelvin Hayden, and for the moment, it's going to be a touchdown.
Here's Freeney coming from his right side, and it was Mathis that hit his arm. I mean, those are the two defensive ends putting on the pressure. Mathis starting on the left side, Freeney starting on the right side. Him in, and he just lifted everything. I mean, he lifted the offense, the defense, the coaching staff, cheerleaders, the owner, PR guy, everything. You're going to see Robert Mathis here with another strip. We saw him, the one on Jeff Garcia, and then we're going to see him get this one. You see how he dips that right shoulder to get underneath John Runyon? And then he takes his left hand and knocks the ball.
First down.
12-yard gain. Drive still alive for the Chiefs. Green buried again.
We can't block him. We can't block him. It was Robert Mathis who came from the other side, and they just had a meeting at the quarterback.
They did it once. They did it once again.
McNair has it slapped out of his hand by Robert Mathis.
Look what they do. Look how this influences the strategy. They'll have this ball near the 40, but the ball is out and still down on the ground, and it looks like the Colts may have it.
That was Robert Mathis that delivers the ball to start the blow. The starting defensive end comes down on the kickoff team. He's been on the kickoff team in the playoffs, and he has been spectacular making big hits, especially in the Baltimore game.
From the 40, Breeze has the ball stripped.
Yeah, we talk about Dwight Freeney coming from the right side, but Robert Mathis coming from the other side is pretty tough too.
Simeon Rice signed this week after being released by Denver in the game. And Brody Coyle, sack, picked up. Dawson.
Robert Mathis came from the outside, Gus, and forced that fumble. And Brody Coyle, it's the one thing you don't want. A sack is one thing. A sack fumble recovery going the other way is as bad as it can get.
Third and seven, pressure from the edges by Mathis, and the ball is out, and it's recovered by Indianapolis.
Robert Mathis going to the right defensive end spot where Dwight Freeney used to be. Just about as fast, coming around the outside. David Garrard has no idea.
Success on these downs, first and second down.
We're on a draw here, and a fumble. McGahee gives it up, and it is picked up by Marlon Jackson, who's inside the 20. Robert Mathis will get credit for forcing the fumble. Number 98, there he is. Left arm gets in there. Ball comes loose.
Key play.
And the ball knocked away from Orton.
Watch Robert Mathis, number 98. He goes right around John Tate and reaches his outside arm, his left arm out, and knocks that ball out of Kyle Orton's hand.
Rosenfeld on the move, chased from behind, lost the football on the ground. Who's got it?
Again, there he is out there with that ball. What an effort. What an effort by Robert Mathis to extend himself and knock the football away from Rosenfels. Look at that. And Sage Rosenfels really lacking awareness.
Look out, ball is stripped. Ball is out, recovered by Baltimore.
Joe Flacco never relax against the Colts.
Tomlinson in the backfield with Rivers. Phillip under pressure, and you've got a strip, you've got a fumble, and you got a recovery, and you got Raheem Brock coming away with it. Robert Mathis came in, knocked the ball loose, forced the fumble.
And they spread the field for Fitzpatrick. Ball pops loose.
At the top of your screen, working against the right tackle, Stacy Andrews, able to get a hand in there and get the ball out.
They need every second they can get. Pennington, look out! Strip sack. The ball was picked up by Vernon Carey. It was Robert Mathis who forced a fumble. So good at it.
The thing about Mathis is when he gets to the passer, he causes a fumble. This guy goes for the sack and the strip. Robert Mathis just caused his 27th fumble in the National Football League. That guy right there, Mathis, doesn't get enough credit.
Wallace getting out of trouble, and the ball is loose, and the Colts may have it. Mathis forced it away, and I believe Tiaho recovered. What a background. Third down and 7. Here comes the pressure. The ball is knocked away. It's a free ball, and the Colts have it, and it's Raheem Brock. And Robert Mathis did it again. He swatted the ball away earlier, and he stripped the ball away here.
Take a look. Robert Mathis once again getting it done. Another strip. Forced fumble.
Four-man rush.
And they get to Brady as he releases the ball.
Robert Mathis has just had a monster game on the outside working against Nick Kazier. Watch the athleticism, the jump for the ball. Good golly. He is the master of that strip sack.
Ooh, boy, yep.
Shaw had it batted out of his hand, picked up by the Colton.
Mathis at the lower right on your screen. Watch him come around the edge and reach in from behind. Sensational work by Robert Mathis. Look at him come in, and with his left hand, as Matt Schaub is starting to start his movement.
And Eli's gonna lose the ball. It's the old sack fumble.
Robert Mathis was just gone by the time Kareem McKenzie got out of his stance.
And they've been long third downs, as is the case here. And Roethlisberger's going to get hit from behind and loses the football. And the king of the sack fumble.
Yeah, no question. These two guys do this on such a regular basis, you can never be surprised by it anymore. Marcus Gilbert thought he did a great job, but when Roethlisberger scrambled, you could see him sort of look back to see where Mathis was.
Easy cut. Nice play. Yates has it knocked out of his hands, and Robert Mathis has got it. Mathis and Freeney, the masters of the sack and slap.
Yeah, at some point, people have to realize how special this kid is. He's on the right-hand side, and right there, both the tight end and the fullback have bypassed him. They're going to leave Winston one-on-one on Mathis. 9 years of production later, why don't you chip him?
Antoine Buffet making as impressive a tackle as you will see in the NFL. As Gabbert sacked, he loses the football at the 37. And let's see what they say. The Colts recover, and it will be Indianapolis football. Robert Mathis made the recovery.
Gabbert from the shotgun. Loses the football, stripped away. And guess who?
Sack for Freeman, 3rd and 13. Tannehill loses the football. It's free.
And here he is rushing the quarterback. Going right by Tyson Klebo.
Four-man rush.
Pressure. Wilson is stripped and is picked up by Indianapolis. He's got to get down here.
Last week and is inactive tonight. And he's stepping away and loses the ball. And the ball will stay in the end zone. The Colts are there. Sheffers is checking. You got Robert Mathis, the master of the sack fumble. They're going to call it a safety, saying that it was recovered out of bounds. But Robert Mathis, who has done this a million times when he's been Peyton's teammate, does it to Manning himself.
Doesn't work on one side, you go to the other side, and there it goes. That was the empty hand.
To the Colts. On third down, Palmer, ball knocked out of his hands.
Yeah, strip sack, 14 and a half now for Mathis. And the 41st time he's forced a fumble.
Big stop here. Bunch formation to the left. Fitzpatrick, ball stripped away. The Colts have it.
Robert Mathis on the sack. Fumble. Unbelievable.
Down to the 7. Johnson in the backfield. Keenum first and 10.
Oh, it's loose. He was racked on the play. It's still bouncing around. It's a safety.
Robert Mathis strikes. We said, if you don't block him, you'll wreck your game plan.
A sack for Mathis, who now breaks the all-time Colt record, passing his former teammate and friend, Dwight Freeney.
On the field.
Davis.
Oh, the ball's on the ground. Colts say they have it. Looked like Robert Mathis was the guy that
reached. When you say that. Smith. Hit from behind. Up in the air. Intercepted by the Colts.
Robert Mathis is disruptive once again. Look at him reach in there with the left arm. Knocks the football out.
Wow.
Wow. Incredible. What a year Robert Mathis is having. Just an extraordinary football season.
Robert Mathis looking to become more of a factor here in the second half. And here comes Mathis to Alex Smith's right. And there's Mathis. And he forces the fumble. And the Colts scrambling after it. But it was Robert Mathis with 19 and a half sacks to lead the NFL. Also a part of his resume, forced fumbles on the run.
That's his 9th forced fumble of the season.
Oh, I never did either. And whoa, and there's a strip sack. Mathis appeared to get in.
Whedon lost the football.
The pressure coming in. It's Mathis with the swat. We talked to him on Friday.
About that very
about
thing.
About that very thing.
Stable of that those defenders would be Robert Mathis in his 14th season. Osweiler, he's going to go down. He's going to lose the ball. And you mentioned Mathis's name. He doesn't have a sack this season, but he gets in there and creates the fumble.
Lamar Miller said, this is not what I signed up for. These are the glory days when they didn't try to go out and get the sack as much as just stripping it. It still counts as a sack. And
45 sack fumbles created in his illustrious career for number 98. Now,
Bradford on this drive, 5 of 5. First and 10, look out from behind. It's a fumble on the play.
Bradford just can't hold the ball, knowing that he's got a really good pass rusher back behind him in Robert Mathis, who for years has done a terrific job stripping the ball when he gets near the quarterback.
Closer, but play resumes nonetheless. 3rd and 8. Football comes loose. Bortles going down, and it's Indianapolis football. Robert Mathis on the recovery.
Robert Mathis making a play in what is expected to be the final game of his 14-year career. He comes on the stunt. He gets the strip, and he gets the recovery of the fumble. Robert Mathis to the rescue.
As he extends his own NFL record, and Zalman will miss seeing him coming around the corner. This was his first ever career strip sack, September 14th, 03, against the late Steve McNair. And then in Peyton Manning's return game in 2013, huge defensive play.
Yeah, that one is the sack heard around the world. Talked about that one all week, and then this one today. His 41st career strip sack, 123rd career sack. And look, he's going to keep that one and hand it over to a loved one.